is like a duck on a pond, the show, isn't it, sometimes? Or feet going under the water. Now, our roving reporter David Robertson has been on some wild and wacky adventures this year, and the next one could probably, quite possibly, be his weirdest. He's the only one who can really introduce this, so let's welcome him to the studio. Sir Robbo.
Oh, my goodness me.
Hello, everyone. Hello, the ladies. How are you?
Wow.
How are you? Do
you have to fit?
Oh, I'll fit all right. Here we go.
Is that heavy?
It's all right. It's okay.
Oh, my God.
Good morning, ladies.
Hello.
Oh, plus and plus. Lovely to see you.
Hello.
Oh, my European.
Very European. Sexy like this.
Yep.
Oh, okay. Hold on a minute.
Sorry, a minute. Oh. Well, comfort is the first thing in medieval fashion, isn't it?
Medieval time.
Oh, okay. Well, yes, John?
I think I speak for all of us in Australia when I say, what's going on?
Well, look, I love medieval times as best as the next person. You know that. And when I got a chance to spend a bit of time with my local enthusiasts, I just jumped at the chance and went to the Abbey, the medieval fair. Take a look at this.
Oh, life is just too fast these days. If only I could take myself back to a simpler time. No, not that simple. I'm talking about a special time when men wore corsets, where there were no forks, and you could get in a lot of trouble for holding a salmon suspiciously. It is, of course, the wonder that was the medieval times. And for a true taste of what life was like, you can go no further than the St Ives Medieval Faire. It's time to get my plague on. From rare diseases to round table dining, the Middle Ages had it all, and I was going to get to relive it. But there were some things that, they needed an update. Oh, excuse me, guys. I understand you're taking requests. I'm wondering if you could play Taylor Swift's Shake It Off. I needed something to make a real statement with. There's so many things that you can experience here at the Medieval Festival, including holding a bird that could probably kill you right where you stand. This is Zorro, and Zorro is a beautiful bird, and I've got Paul here. Paul, tell me, what's Zorro's story?
Zorro's an Australian wedge-tailed eagle.
Yeah.
He was born in a zoo.
Well, I was impressed, but you know the old saying, keep your friends close and your enemies closer. So I need a little more info on my new wingman. How much meat on this bird if I was to cook it?
Very little. He weighs about 3.2 kilograms, but he can take down prey as large as, say, an elk or a stag.
OK, let's get the bird back now. Thank you, Zorro and Paul. I love the wildlife. Well, I wasn't going to be chowing down on Zorro anytime soon. Well, a starchy snack would have to do. Now I was fed, I was ready to be entertained. Medieval style.
Welcome to the World Jousting Championships from the St. Ives Medieval Faire. It's coming to you live on your home of Jousting, the 10 Network. I'm your host, Colin McKittrick. Of course, I'm joined by a man who knows the way of the joust. It is Slade McGee.
Thank you, Colin. I don't know about the way of the joust, but I certainly know the excitement that is out in that field today. It is going to be huge. Well, the Red Knight, Sir Philip Leach, going up against the White Knight, Sir Arne Coates, for what is bound to be the biggest joust of 2015.
Oh, my goodness. 16 wins.
16 wins. And part of that has been due to his waist and neck hits of 14. That is a great number. But this next number, tell us about it, Colin, because this is huge.
But if you aren't on horsing your opponent, you are not going to be winning these jousts.
Well, go home, Colin. Got favorites earned three times. We've got Lady Ida, beautiful. Princess Leia and Queen Latifah with a total points of 74. We've also got Sir Arne Coates, who's, well, not as squeaky clean. Tell us about it, Colin.
Pretty dirty. He's bribed three times. I can't believe this. Well, because you can risk disqualification. Favors earned Lady Gaga.
But a great one to have. If you're going to have one, you want to have Lady Gaga. You certainly don't want Danny Minogue, and you don't
Absolutely
want Kylie
not.
Minogue.
57 points total.
This is going to be a textbook game of jousting. If you want to see how to play joust, you want to see this one right here. It's the joust of the century, and I believe we've got our man on the ground.
Oh, Sir Blair, he is itching to go, Slade, so let's head over to him right now.
All right. Thank you, good gentles, back in our main studio. Yes, here at St. Ives, today we are all a titter. Will there be blood and thunder? There certainly will be thundering hooves. There will be great lance shots. So make sure you're tuned in, because this will be the greatest event you have ever seen.
About 45 people died on the day, actually, during those sports. I'm only kidding. It was a fantastic
but
day.
But Ivanhoe, thank heavens you're safe.
Oh, I am safe, and I'm ready to take you off on my steed, Ita Buttrose.
Oh, thank you, Ivanhoe.
Yes. And we obviously want to thank all the good folk at the St Ives Medieval Faire for letting us come and explore. And also, for my wonderfully armour today, the fair will be happening on the 24th and the 25th of September next year, and you will want to get onto it. It is
get into it quick.
So much fun. There's food there, there's activities, there's women, there's men, and there's death. What more could you want?
A can of WD-40, maybe? Well, I'm a little bit squeaky,
and my hair is... Ooh.
Can anybody joust?
Anyone can joust. You just got to have your jousting, sticks. Talents. Sticks, yeah. It's got to be big enough.
Jousting sticks. Tell him he's dreaming.
Okay, thanks.
It's strange, because a lot of the competitors take it really seriously, but really it's joust for fun.